Hey there guys, how you all doing? Welcome back to the Ultimate RTG. So in the last one, we did go out and purchase the 95 rated Neymar, and I know a load of you were definitely down for that decision because you wanted to see how he would play for me, and then maybe if you like the look of him, you can go and purchase him for your own teams. A few of you were a little bit disappointed with that decision because you thought I was going to go out and purchase Ronaldinho or unlock the icon SBC. The good news is that we are going to be doing the SBC. I just don't know whether or not we're going to be selling Ronaldo to bring in the coins to afford him, because the way I see it is if we continue using Ronaldo and don't sell him, I really want to be playing Ronaldinho as the cam, the middle cam, not the wide cam, middle cam or the striker. The thing is, if we keep Ronaldo, then Del Piero would be pushed out wide and he doesn't make a good wide cam at all. So that got me thinking, maybe it's time that we part ways with Del Piero. And I know a lot of you will say, oh my god, you can't do that, Fuji, he's your best player. We could always buy him back in the long run. And for how much he cost with Aubameyang that we pulled at the time, I think we even got Kante, the price was brought down to the point where we unlocked him for about 380,000-400,000 coins. Del Piero for 380,000. Now that is pretty cheap. And if we use him in the main challenge for the icon Ronaldinho, and as you're seeing on your screen, we've unlocked Deco for just shy of 400,000 coins, which is pretty good. We are preparing the club to unlock Ronaldinho. I just don't know, like I said, what we're going to be doing, what move we're going to be making to really bring Ronaldinho in to start off with, and where are we going to play him? Because if we continue using Ronaldo, he's going to have to be played as the striker, Ronaldinho as the cam. Do you see what I mean? It's a little bit hectic right now, but to prepare the club, I know that you gave me some advice in the last episode suggesting to unlock Perez, Deco, and Overmars, those SBCs. Well, right now, if we do decide to use Del Piero, then I've got, well, Deco that we've completed, and you're going to be seeing the packs on your screen. So the club is ready. We just need a really good monthly finish for this weekend. We are 15-0 as it stands, so we're going to be playing some live games in the weekend league. If we can somehow creep into the top 100 and get another icon, that would be perfect. So maybe we should hold off and see where we finish this weekend, and then that will basically pave the way to what decision we decide to make. So hopefully you like the sound of that. Leave a like on today's video. We've got an SBC to go and complete, and then I'll let you know if Neymar's been playing well. Let's go. So we do have another one of these to celebrate the FIFA Global Series, and I've been watching the Twitch stream myself every single day, and as a fan of FIFA and a fan of eSport, even I have no idea as to what's going on. The way it's been put together, very poor, and if you're a neutral looking in on that, you've got no hope, really. And the amount of technical issues going down, day one, I was told that the pros had to wait 8 to 9 hours to play two games. How would you build up momentum from that? How do you psych yourself up for these games? It must be very difficult for them. And they even cut to a friendly between two of the Dutch pros scoring their own goals. Like, how does that look if you've just tuned into the stream? It is an absolute mess. Like, last year was pretty bad. This year, I would say it's got worse. EA need to step up their game and fix their game, fix the no loss glitch and all that rubbish. But anyway, one premium gold players pack, 5 leagues exactly. This wasn't even that hard, and we're getting a gold players pack. So let's hope that we can get a few more coins and get back up to that 400k mark. Let's hope for something special today. Go on, EA. A walkout, start off the episode, get me hyped for today's games. The mega packs recently, in the last episode, they weren't too good. We've got Henderson, 82 Henderson. I hope that the luck, when we do eventually get around to unlocking the Ronaldinho SBC, we get some really big pulls. Maybe even an icon. I know that a lot of people that have been completing the top tier, I mean Thierry Henry, Matthias, Ronaldinho, I hope that we do get lucky and pull like an icon. So I did see someone in the comments getting themselves confused, because in the last episode, we were trying out different players in a new team, and they thought we had dropped Messi from our weekly side. No way. Messi is still rocking it in that left attacking midfield position, and his stats are pretty good. And what I've decided to do actually in-game is tell him to stay forward as a left attacking mid. Most of the time in the 4-2-3-1, I don't even tell my middle cam to stay forward. I like it when Del Piero tracks back. But for Messi, with him, he won't always stay forward, but most of the time you will be able to catch your opponents out on the counter. So I like him in that position, just another playmaker in the attack. So Messi is smashing it. Neymar, I'm enjoying. I like the way he feels on the ball, his acceleration. And someone asked me on Twitter, are you going to keep him after this week in league? If he continues playing like the way he is, then yeah, for sure. 21 games, 11 goals, 11 assists. And that's not bad, actually, because of what I've got in the side, like the quality of striker, which is Ronaldo, Del Piero scoring goals. So it kind of overshadows players at times. And Neymar is still just turning up for me. So we're ready to go and play the week in league. We've got Lozano and Alessandrini on the bench. Where are we, though? Monthly rank. So I've only played 15 games. The gameplay on Friday and Saturday, it wasn't that good. So hopefully today it feels a bit better. Monthly is looking like this. 122, 127. We need realistically, maybe 37, 38 wins this weekend. We can do it, that's the thing, but I don't know. I don't know if we're going to be able to clutch it out. Please, pray for me right now. Get those emojis in the comment section. And let's go smash up the week in league. The first game of today, Rui Costa. Now, it will be typical if he ends up scoring a hat-trick against me. But from what I've played, he does miss quite a few. Oh, that's close to getting that. Well done, Neymar. Good interception. Let's build up from that. Ronaldo wants it straight through. If I can turn him, finish. What a start to the weekend league. Well, what a start to halfway through the weekend league. We're not even halfway. No, we are. We are halfway. We've played. No, we're not. I thought we played 25 games. We've only played 15 games. Come on, I need to start getting through them. Down the line to Messi. Well, it's overlapping. I'm going to cut that inside. Ronaldo. He didn't even close me down there. There was so much time and space to pick my shot. I was going to rush it. We need a lot of these today. First rage quit of the day. Let's go. Game two, guys. Alessandrini, Petit. You know what, actually? I need to try Petit. Every time I come up against him, interception machine. You can see the kind of style that he's taking up when it comes to defending. It's not really going to close me down that much. He's just going to really hold his line, hold his position. Messi. I was looking for that driven strike near post. Ramos. Del Piero. Little cut back. Through. Finish. Ramos. Oh, it's all right. We've got a corner. I'll drill this one front post. I've been doing this a lot lately and it has worked. I don't actually like Vieira doing it. Vieira just seems, I don't know, he doesn't jump properly. Ramos, though. Oh, that was poor. Yeah, he's going to look to frustrate me. Play it around. This is what I'm used to, though. Most of the time, players do play like this when they see my team. So I'm not going to let it affect me as much. You're coming into a competitive game mode and you're playing like this. It's just, I don't get it. Like, what's the point of even playing if you're going to decide to play like this? I'm in a game right now where this person has literally just held the ball between his centre-backs for the whole match. What's the point, man? Seriously. If I can score from kickoff, that'd be absolutely fantastic. And I'm going to go for goal. Edison, he has to make that save. This is really irritating me right now. And he ends up scoring that. Come on, Vieira. Big win, please. I don't know why. Ronaldo, finish. Let's go, Neymar. 1-1. God, does that feel good against someone who's playing like this. Come on, Neymar, get this goal. Come on, lad. Please. Neymar, across goal. Yes, let's go. What a goal. That feels so good again. Yes. If I can get that next goal, that is game over for him. Play it. Across. Neymar's there. Hat-trick for Neymar. What a player. He has actually changed the game for me. If it wasn't for him with that 5-star weak foot to score in that position. 7 chem and he's gone. That last game has put me in a bad mood right now. And we're facing a very strong team. As long as he plays properly, I don't care about a loss. But to play that game. Well done. That's good. Neymar's through. Neymar! He has a precise shot. And I know that the non-inform is still a very good card. But this one, well, the other informs, once you start bringing in those informs, you will notice a very, very good finish. I like him. Oh my god. I am just so triggered from that last game. My adrenaline is really high. Come on, Ronaldo. Yes, lovely play. Del Piero. Oh, nearly. He nearly went in. Good ball. Messi, that a cross finish. We need these goals. Let's go. Del Piero. Ah. Messi, get there. Well done. Keep this pressure up. I like this. Neymar is in open space again, and he's not missing. Oh my. I'm going to keep Neymar. I think Neymar is going to get kept. I might even sell this one and buy his one to watch. Seriously. Love him. What a player in that right attacking midfield position. Surprisingly, we got a rage quit. I didn't think so with the team that he was using. Yep, he's quit. 3-0. Great result. The last game for today's episode. I can't play anymore. I need a break. The past two have taken it out of me. Don't know what he was doing with that. Quick early goal. Early goal. Del Piero. Oh, no. 1 minute 36. A quick rage quit. Come on. Let's go, please. And that, my friends, is how you win in Foot Champs. Score those early goals, force the rage quits. No, seriously, though. From a kickoff, it just is impossible. Next week, I won't be doing that. So we do finish off on 19-0, and that right there is a fantastic platform to build up on. I don't know if 37 or 38 wins is going to be good enough to finish in the top 100. All that I know is that there is one player in this team that is absolutely smashing it, and he came in clutch against the player who was, well, decided to play like an absolute tool, holding possession for the majority of the game. Neymar got that all-important goal, and one thing to pay attention to is I didn't really lose my cool that much, although I was getting agitated and frustrated with him in the match. I didn't change my structure at the back. I didn't throw everybody forward. Even when I went a goal down, I tried to put on pressure to the point where I was still strong in the midfield, but I was closing him down and trying to force him to make the mistake. And that's what I'd recommend. If you come up against someone like that, I know that it is annoying, and yes, I did lose my cool. Just try and keep as calm as possible, because as much as he's holding the ball, he will eventually make a mistake, and we were able to force him into a rage quit, which was satisfying. So he was annoying, and then the next game, I had my adrenaline pumping, and that guy had a great team, but we won 3-0, and the last match, well, he just quit. So Neymar, I mean, the thing with this card, he has the added stats, which you can feel in-game, and when he takes those shots, clinical, arrows in every single time, and I am considering maybe selling this card and bringing in that one to watch, so just in case he gets another in-form, 96 overall Neymar. His team of the season is going to be unbelievable. I will 100% get around to bringing in Neymar's team of the season as well. But right now, having him as a right attacking mid, he is a winger, so it works so well. And with that five-star weak foot, you can cut in and finesse it, or you can shoot across goal. He's perfect. And even on 7 chemistry, well, that doesn't make any difference at all. So Neymar is destroying. We've got 21 games to be played later on tonight. Oh, please, send me your luck. I hope that I don't face too many of those opponents keeping the ball like that. Otherwise, I could have quite easily lost that. That scared me a little bit. But with a one-to-watch cards coming out, I think on the 2nd, it's a good idea that we start getting those packs ready through the Ronaldinho SBC. So if we pack a one-to-watch, who knows? Who's going to get one? Mkhitaryan, Sanchez, if we get one of them, they could be worth like 500,000 to 600,000, 700,000 coins, and that would be pretty much paying for the Ronaldinho SBC. So that's what we're going to do. We'll hold on to the packs, we'll open them once the one to watch cards are in packs, and please do advise me on what I should do. Do you want me to submit Del Piero and then use Ronaldinho as our cam going forward, or should we keep Del Piero? Should we sell Ronaldo? Because the thing is, I guess we could use Ronaldinho as the left attacking mid, but it is a waste. I really do like him as a striker or as a cam. So please let me know in the comment section what you want me to do. Drop a like on the video, and I will see you on the next one. Team out. Peace.